Hello and welcome to this edition of Editor's Take on www.liveman.com. The Reserve Bank of India today announced its new monetary policy and it cut its key repo rate by 25 basis points and left the cash reserve ratio unchanged. To discuss what the RBI has done today and what it could be doing in the future, I have with me my colleague Tamal Bandyopadhyay, who is the Deputy Managing Editor of Mint and our in-house banking expert. So Tamal, first reactions?
Well, it's on the predicted line. 25 basis point rate cut and no CRR cut. That was a wide expectation from the market. So that's what he has done. But I think more important than the action is what he spoke, the so-called
the guidance.
Yes, where he has categorically said that the scope for further cut is very limited. Which is why we have seen how this stock market behave, even the money market also behaved, I mean the bond market. Of course, to what extent it's attributable to Reserve Bank of India policy and
yes,
the politics of the day, we don't know. But certainly that's something one should have its concern, because till now all the analysts and economists had been talking about between 50 and 70 basis point cut till December. But now it seems that that window is not that wide.
Okay. So what was Subbarao's reasoning now? Why is he indicating that he does not have enough space for further interest rate cuts? Because the undertone is extremely hawkish.
Yeah, I think inflation continues to remain a concern. You know, retail inflation is in double digit. Wholesale inflation is not at all. I mean, the new normal is 6% plus, that kind of stuff. But still, it is there very much, even though the core inflation has come down below 4%. And then you have your current account deficit about 5% record high. So all these things put together, the government needs to convince the Reserve Bank of India that it is firm on its fiscal consolidation path. And yes, indeed, P. Chidambaram has laid out the roadmap. But we need to see that whether he will be able to stick to the roadmap and indeed the fiscal deficit he is able to bring down, so on and so forth. So it's a tough call. I think RBI has lobbed the ball back to the government's court.
Yes. And what do you think in the future, what the government needs to do to convince the Reserve Bank? Because Chidambaram obviously wants lower interest rates. That's what he keeps signaling. And Subbarao has in a way agreed to sort of cooperate with him this time, but you know, raised a big question mark. So would the fiscal side of it be the main signal that if they can keep control over costs, would that be, or spending rather, would that be the main thing RBI would be looking at?
I think yeah, we would need a situation where you have a very tight fiscal policy and relatively loose monetary policy to get back out of the mess. In fact, Reserve Bank of India's document, the statement you have seen, it's categorically said that interest rate cannot be the only growth driver.
Yes.
The government needs to address the supply side issues, the infrastructure,
indeed,
so on and so forth. So this government has all along been taking the easy way out, you know, the pump in subsidy and look at the administered prices. So that's how you take care of the various
yeah,
constituents, the board bank. So you need to cut down on subsidies, you need to cut down the you need to lift all the administered prices, you need to address the regulatory issues in terms of land and mining and labor, and you need to, you know, the real sector reforms you need to bring in, then only can monetary
policy. So the answer is actually in New Delhi, not in Mumbai.
Yes,
in that sense.
Yes.
One last question, Tamal, that even while as we've discussed the guidance and the interest rate trajectory in the future, he has cut rates today. Do you think the banks are going to oblige by cutting their lending rates?
No.
Or will the monetary transmission be happening?
No, won't happen.
Okay.
I think the banking segment in India is looking more for CRR cut than an interest rate cut to pass on the benefit, because interest rate cut per se doesn't affect bank much in either way, because they, unlike say US and other developed markets, they don't depend too much on money market. Their main resources is bank deposits.
Yes.
And they're not able to cut down the bank deposit rates, because in the fiscal year so far, now we are coming to the close of the year, banks' credit growth is higher than the deposit growth. So in order to attract depositors, they will continue to offer relatively higher interest rate to depositors.
Mm-hmm.
And in such a situation, you can't cut down your loan rates.
Yeah. Thanks, Tamal.
Yeah.
So that was Tamal Bandyopadhyay explaining why the RBI has cut interest rates right now. Also, why its guidance has been hawkish. He said that the RBI, in a sense, has lobbed the ball back into the court of the government. And finally, he has put out a warning that even while the policy rate is down by 25 basis points, companies and consumers should not expect their actual cost of borrowing to go down. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot, Tamal. And do log in to www.livemint.com for further videos. Thank you.